Hi guys, this is the last topic of your chapter 1 in which we are going to talk about the phenomena of evaporation, and we will also understand that what is the difference between evaporation and boiling. Now I'm sure by this time you already know that in both of these processes the state of matter is changing from liquid to the gas or the vapor form, right? But then where lies the difference between evaporation and boiling? What happens is that, you know, when there is a specific compound and you start heating it up, that means you're providing heat energy to it. A certain point will come that, you know, when all the bonds inside it will start breaking up. That means all this heat will be used in the form of latent heat of vaporization, and eventually it will change to the gaseous form. But this whole thing will be happening at a specific temperature. Different compounds have different boiling point and different this specific temperature, right? So what is evaporation then? Now, since if we talk about this element only, suppose if it has a boiling point of 78 degree Celsius. Now, if this element changes its state from liquid to gas at any temperature below 78 degree, then that is called evaporation. That means at any temperature when the state of matter is changing its state below this boiling point, then that is known as evaporation. This is the major difference, that evaporation is always occurring below the boiling point that is there, and this occurs at a specific boiling point. That means at a specific temperature it is occurring. This is the main difference. Apart from that, boiling is a bulk phenomena. What do we mean by that? Boiling is a bulk phenomena. Let's see here. Suppose when you are heating up this liquid over here and you're providing heat energy, so the heat is getting distributed evenly throughout, and eventually whole of the liquid starts getting changed into the gaseous form. Whereas in evaporation, the molecules that are there near the surface over here, they are the one which, you know, start evaporating, start changing their state. So this is known as a surface phenomena. Evaporation is known as a surface phenomena, and boiling is known as a bulk phenomena. That means it is happening in whole of this liquid, right? So this is let me explain you up here again. So if this is the liquid in this container, you know, there are different molecules over here, particles that are there. Now what happens is the particles that are near the surface, that is just at the brim, at the edge, they have comparatively higher kinetic energy over here, and that is the reason why some of these particles are able to break free from the forces of attraction and they go to the next state. So when these particles near the surface, they are able to break away from the forces of attraction of other particles, they get changed into the vapor form. So this is how basically evaporation occurs, and it occurs only at the surface. So it is a surface phenomena, right? Now let us see that what are the factors that affect evaporation. Now evaporation has many factors on which it depends. For example, wind speed, surface area, temperature and humidity. Let us consider each one of these cases. For example, if we talk about wind speed, obviously as the wind speed is going to increase, the rate of evaporation will also increase, right? And surface area, this is a very common example. Like if you have to dry up your wet clothes, what you do is you basically spread them up so that, you know, their surface area increases. So that is how, you know, they are getting a more wider surface from where they can evaporate, from where they can break free from the forces of attraction of other molecule. So here also, as the evaporation increase, as the surface area increase, the evaporation increases. And for temperature, obviously, as the temperature is increasing, that means you are increasing the heat energy, then obviously the evaporation is going to increase, its rate is going to increase. Lastly is about humidity. Humidity, by that we mean that how much moisture is there in the air. Now this is something which inversely affects the evaporation. That means if the humidity is going to increase, the rate of evaporation will decrease, and if humidity will decrease, the evaporation rate will increase. Why is this so? Because the air around us also has a specific capacity to hold a certain moisture. If it already has a lot of moisture and humidity in it, it will not accept more water molecules from the clothes or from any other wet surface. So that is why humidity is basically inversely proportional to rate of evaporation. This is how we write inversely proportional. If you remember, we had talked about this when we were talking about density, right? If you remember that density is equal to mass upon volume, where density is inversely proportional to volume. Inversely proportional means when one thing increases, the other thing decreases, and vice versa. Lastly, let's take one after effect of evaporation. The after effect of evaporation is that whenever evaporation takes place, it causes cooling in the surrounding area. Now let us consider this case. Suppose if you put some acetone on your hand. Acetone is the nail polish remover. I hope you would be knowing this. Now you will observe that it quickly, you know, evaporates up. And what do you observe after then? Do you observe that you feel some cold or some little coolness on your hand? Why is that so? Because evaporation causes cooling. But why does it cause the cooling? This is because this acetone, in order to change its state from the liquid to the gaseous form or the vapor form, it requires energy. And where is this liquid getting the energy from? It is getting the energy from your hand. So obviously when the hand is losing energy, what will happen? It will be cooled. That is why your palm basically feels cooling effect when, you know, you put acetone on your hand. Other such more common example of this phenomena that evaporation causes cooling are that, you know, you might have heard that people sprinkle water on the roof or the terrace of house during summers. Why is that so? Like, you know, what happens is at the terrace, if you add some water, obviously this water is going to evaporate by absorbing the energy from the roof, and the roof becomes cool, and obviously the floors which are below this, they also become cooler than before. So this is one such example. Apart from this, the main thing is that once a thing absorbs the energy from the surroundings, that surrounding will get cooled up. So this is all about evaporation and the difference between evaporation and boiling. And this we cover up all the topics of chapter 1, matter in our surroundings. The major points, like what is matter, what is its classification, what are its characteristics, should be very clear in order to understand the next chapters of the chemistry portion. So make sure that you are clear and well understood of all the concepts of matter, right? Till then, do revise and keep learning. Thank you.